Hello everyone and welcome. We are inside the 2017 Nissan Frontier Pro-4X and we're going to be doing some testing to show the differences between two-wheel drive, four-high, and four-low. Now the Pro-4X adds some off-road goodies to the base Frontier and you know before we get into these tests, we're going to go to a little whiteboard session and talk about how this all-wheel drive system is well suited for off-road conditions. Here we have a drawing of what the four-wheel drive system on the Frontier Pro-4X looks like, and it's kind of expanded out so we can see all of the components. So you've got the engine that, of course, sends power to the transmission. That will then go to a high or low gear reduction, and then this is everything in blue here is the transfer case. So there's a chain connecting what will eventually be the output shaft for the rear differential connecting to the output shaft for the front differential. And so there you can see that. And typically with part-time four-wheel drive systems, systems where you can switch from two-wheel drive to four-wheel drive, you're not going to have any slip within this transfer case. These can be gear or chain driven. Chain tends to be more common these days. And in the rear, you've got an electronic locking differential. And then up front, you have an open differential. Now, Nissan also employs what they call active brake limited slip on all four wheels. So if you have this rear differential open and you start to have slip on one of them, it will brake that tire to send power, to send more torque to the other tire, which does have grip. Of course, if you have it locked, there's no need for that. It will automatically do that. And then on the front axle, of course, having that open will be useful there. And so I've got two different scenarios to kind of talk about, you know, what will this all-wheel drive system be doing and why is it beneficial for off-road? So our first scenario, we have one tire without traction. So we could say, for example, that this tire is up in the air, it's on some ice, but worst case, let's just say it's up in the air. So you may think, all right, well, because this is an open differential up front and that tire is in the air, it's simply going to spin. But it actually can't, because if you lock the center, which is what this transfer case will be doing, and you lock the rear, now you've locked these two speeds together. So if this tire is going to spin, it requires rotating this shaft. And if this shaft is rotating, it requires rotating this shaft. And if this is rotating, it means both of these are rotating. So in order for that to spin, both of the rear tires also have to spin. And because they have traction, this won't spin and you'll simply move on, no issues. Let's move on to a kind of worst case scenario, something much worse than that. Let's say you have three tires in the air or three tires on ice, because three tires in the air isn't really realistic, but you get the idea. It is possible, if you had those three tires in the air, that all three of those could spin, because these are linked, this is open, so it's going to allow for a speed differential here, but this will rotate at the same speed as these. And so it's possible that you have all three of those rotating together. But then, of course, you do have that four-wheel ABLS, so you can brake that front left tire, and that prevents everything from spinning. And then as a result, it gives more torque to the wheel, which is on the ground, and you accelerate forward. So, you know, when you do have a locked center and a locked rear, it really does open up the possibilities as far as, you know, there are very few circumstances in which, you know, obviously this has got three tires in the air and you're still going to be able to send torque to that wheel. So very few scenarios where it isn't effective. So now we'll head back into the car and do some acceleration testing and show the differences between accelerating with just the rear, with all four, and then if you put it into that low gear range. Okay, so the first test I'm going to run is two-wheel drive. So this is going to be the rear tires only, and it's going to have traction control off. And the way I'm going to do it is just lift my foot from the brake and mash it on the accelerator pedal. Now, you'll get a better start if you hold your foot on the brake and the accelerator pedal and let off the brake. But I don't want to do that because I don't want to do it in four low, where you have a huge torque advantage and could potentially cause problems. That's not something you'd want to do. You don't want to launch in four low with your foot on the gas and the brakes. So we're going to do every one the same. Start with the foot on the left pedal, move over to the right pedal, and just floor it and let the traction control sort it out. This one won't have traction control on. We'll see if there's wheel slip. Start of our first test, traction control off, two-wheel drive. And there was no wheel slip with traction control off, so I don't expect that to be much different with traction control on. We'll go ahead and turn around and do it again with traction control on. So that was a 0 to 30 time of 3.5 seconds. Okay, traction control is on, two-wheel drive. And And once again, we have a 0 to 30 time of 3.5 seconds. So as I expected, because there wasn't any wheel slip, it was actually the same time with traction control on and off, just flooring it, just not enough torque to really get things spinning. Now we'll go ahead and try it in four-wheel drive high. And you know, because there's no slip, you probably won't expect to see much difference there, because four-wheel drive isn't really going to add any additional traction since it's not slipping in two-wheel drive. But we will see the gearing difference once we put it in four low. Now remember, when you're doing this, you don't want to put a part-time four-wheel drive vehicle in four-wheel drive on pavement. The only reason I'm going to do it here is because I'm going in a straight line. So all the wheels are traveling at the exact same speed, and it's okay to do. And then once I get to the end of the run, I'm going to take it out of four-wheel drive so I can turn around. But basically, you never want to use part-time four-wheel drive on pavement because you'll have some bindage in that all-wheel drive system. It doesn't allow for the difference in wheel speeds that you have while turning. So you know what's interesting about that is, because you're going to have more power losses when putting it in four-wheel drive versus just letting it do it in two-wheel drive, it looks like some of those losses actually materialized into a slower 0 to 60 time or 0 to 30 time. Not a huge difference, 3.55 seconds versus 3.49 with the traction control on and in rear-wheel drive, but still a difference nonetheless. So you have less power at the wheels when you're in four-wheel drive. But you have more grip. So if this car had more power, you would see a better acceleration time. Because it doesn't have more power and because it won't slip in two-wheel drive, you actually don't see that. You see the opposite, and you see a slower 0 to 30 time in four-wheel drive. Now finally, we'll put it in four low, and this will give us an advantage in gearing, so hopefully we'll see a quicker time. Put it in neutral, over to four high, put it in four low. Traction control automatically goes off, back into drive, pull up to our starting line, and start our test. It feels quicker. You definitely feel the gearing advantage. And yep, it was quicker, 3.2 seconds, so better than our two-wheel drive version by about a quarter of a second, and you know, better than our four-wheel drive version in four high. So cool to actually see the differences in gearing there and see, you know, based on which drive mode you're in, how much acceleration you're going to have. Remember, this is always going to be traction limited, so in four-wheel drive, you will have an advantage when there isn't good traction. This is done on a road, so there's great traction. So, thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.